Joel and I had a privilege of meeting with Minister Shaked just a few months after her appointment as a Minister of Justice. We saw that she accomplished a lot for sovereignty of Israel. Please join me in welcoming Minister of Justice, Ayelet Shaked.
Thank you.
Minister Shaked, how is it to be being Justice Minister of Israel?
It is a great honor for me. Actually, from time to time, every like few months, I'm stopping my work for a moment and tell myself, wow, we are the justice minister of a Jewish state in Israel. It's not something obvious if you look down to our history, and definitely it's a very important role. The justice ministry is a very strong ministry. I'm the head of the committee that decide which legislation will pass and which legislation will not. So it is very powerful position in Israel, and I try to do my best to serve the entire people of Israel, and I hope that I did a good job. It's like almost 3.5 years now, and I hope that I will have more years to serve in this ministry.
Right. How do you see the rule of law in Israel?
Israel has a very strong judicial system, and Israel is a very strong democracy. By the way, Israel is part of a very exclusive club of 21 countries that were established as a democratic state. And therefore, we have a very strong democratic values, a very strong judicial system, of course, independent judges like in all other democracies in the world, a very professional system. I try to balance it, as I said, from a perspective of conservative and liberal. I had the opportunity to be the head of the committee that select 40% of the Supreme Court, 6 judges out of 15. And I hope that I succeed to change the spirit a bit and to shift the entire system from the liberal side to the conservative side. In general, we have in the judicial system 800 judges. In my term, we nominate 300 out of them. And again, I hope that I succeed to do a change. But we have a very strong and professional system.
That's great. How do you see the solution to the southern part of Israel with the Gaza Strip?
We need to understand first how we got to where we are. In 2005, Ariel Sharon, his back then the prime minister, led the disengagement from Gaza, and we withdrew till the last inch, ruining all the villages there, and we got in return only missiles and tunnels and terror. A year after that, in 2006, United States forced election in Gaza, and we got the Hamas, which is a terror organization who rule today in Gaza Strip. Unfortunately, I don't see the future in pink colors, because there are many people there in Gaza that support the Hamas and encourage this terror organization. Of course, they are very miserable there. And we have also a very tough situation in all the south. You know, I think that Israel is the only Western country whose citizens are getting missiles on a monthly basis. We can win this battle. I think that we should be very strong against the Hamas to operate forces in the south to be more tough on these terror attacks. But if you ask me what will be the far future, then it's very hard to tell. I think that the Hamas is becoming stronger and stronger. From year to year, it becomes stronger and stronger. And I definitely think that one of the Israel goals is to weaken this terror organization. And definitely, I will be happy if United States and the other Western countries will help.
Right, and that's the next question, actually. The Trump administration is due to unveil the peace plan between Israel and Palestinians. So what are your thoughts about it and advice?
I can tell you the truth, I think it's a waste of time. I don't think that there is a chance in the current future to make a peace in the Middle East. I think that Abu Mazen, Mahmoud Abbas, is not there. The gaps between the Palestinians and Israel is much too big in order to be bridged. And the fact that there is a state already in Gaza, a terror state, but there is a state in Gaza, there is the Palestinian Authority in Judea and Samaria. They fight against each other all the time. By the way, one of the reasons that we are in such a bad situation in Gaza is because of Abu Mazen, who try to push Israel not to give electricity and things to Gaza. So this is very complicated. They are fighting one another. I don't think that there is a chance in the current future for a peace process or a peace plan. Not in the current future.
And what can we do to further strengthen U.S.-Israel ties?
I think that the relationships are very close, and Israel and the United States shared the same values, and this is why I think the allies is so strong. Of course, we always need to keep open dialogue between the administration, and we are in this administration very happy that we have full support in the United Nations, which is a very hostile organization in our minds and very biased against Israel. So if you ask me, we just need to continue the good relationships that we have.
Right. And the final question, when do you anticipate general elections to happen? And do you think and do you see yourself running as a prime minister?
I think that the election will be in March, in my mind. This is what I think, actually. And I hope the party that I belong to will be a strong party. It is the right-wing ideological party in Israel. And I think that we need to be strong in order to execute what we want to do.
Right. In the near future, perhaps?
I think that I hope that the next government will be a right-wing government there, and we are the biggest party in the coalition.
Okay. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much.